Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is LJ and in today's video I am going to be doing a 3 looks, 1 palette using the Madison Dare to Blend palette. This palette is from a brand called Madison. They are an Irish brand. They have all our social medias, which I will link down below. This palette is available worldwide, so I'll also link that down below if you do want to check it out for yourself. I'm sharing with you 3 looks today in this palette, but I also have some thoughts on the palette, the formula, the blend and everything, so I'll leave that to the very end. This palette is also in collaboration with another YouTuber called Amy's Makeup Box, who I have been following for a very long time. She's an amazing makeup artist, so definitely go check her out as well. Without further ado, let's get on to the 3 tutorials, the 3 looks that I created using this palette.
This is what the Madison Dare to Blend palette looks like, and this is look number 1. So first I am going into vanilla, into the crease. All of the brushes I'm using are going to be on the screen. The next shade I'm using is plum, so this is going to be more of a purpley pinky kind of a look. So I'm just saturating that into the crease of both eyes, and then I'm bringing it down into the outer corner of each eye. Here I'm just blending out the edges just to make sure that they look really super smooth, and I'm also bringing that plum shade down to the lower lash line. P. Louise Base is going to cut the crease out for us. I'm using the Inglot 9S brush and I'm just creating a half moon shape on the lid and then blending out the harsh edges with my finger. Next up, we're going to add some shimmer. I'm starting off with the shade Champagne, which is a lighter tone, and then going on with Rose closer to the lash line, and that's going to give you a nice blend of the shimmer shades. And then I'm going to get some plum again and tidy up around the edges, making sure the blend is perfect next to the shimmer shades and on top where the crease is cut. So I'm going to give myself a small little bit of a winged liner using the Essence liquid ink. And then I am going to go into Smoke, which is the black shade, and line the lower lashes. I'm using a purple eyeliner into the waterline, just to give us a little pop of colour. I'm using my favourite lower lash line, Inglot Mascara, and some lashes from Beaut Essentials website. I also have a discount code with those guys, so that will be listed below. And this is look number 1. Next up we have more of a smoky brown look. I'm starting off the look by going into Hush, into the crease and the lower lash line. Then I'm grabbing the shade Hickory and I'm saturating that on the outer corner of the eyeball and also the inner corner. So we're going to create a little space in the middle there. I'm also replicating the shape on the lower lash line. Using my finger, I'm dabbing on the shade Chocolate on the space we created. I also added Champagne on the inner corner, blending it out with a fluffy brush, and I am adding some black eyeliner nice and softly onto the top lash line and the lower lash line. This is using the shade Smoke from the palette. This Inglot gel liner is going into my waterline and it's going to be another pop of colour, just to give us a little bit more creativity going on with the look. I'm adding some Glamify lashes. These are lovely, nice, soft and natural, and that is look number 2. Next up we have more of a fiery, smoky, warm look. Starting off the look by going into Toffee into the crease, and then adding Blazing on the outer corner. And we're going to create a lovely blend of warm shades, just making sure everything is blended together with a fluffy brush. Mulberry is a most stunning orange shade in the palette. It is absolutely gorgeous. Then I'm adding Gold into the inner corner and underneath on the inner corner as well. Sigma Black Liner Gel is going to go on top, underneath and inside on the tight line and waterline, and then we're going to smoke it out with Smoke. and we're going to create that beautiful ombre. We're just not going to wing it out, we're just going to blur out the black liner. Then Mulberry is going to go into the lower lash line, whack on some mascara, pop the lashes on the same as look number two, and that is look number three complete.
Okay guys, those are the three looks that I created using the palette. Now let's get on to my thoughts on the palette. The palette packaging is in cardboard. There is no mirror, which I do feel like is a downfall for such a big palette. On the inside you just have a little note from Amy, hello babes, hashtag do you dare, and then Madison. So I feel like this palette would really benefit with a mirror here. And it has everything you need here to create a basic look. So the three looks that I created are looks that I tried to kind of push the boundaries on the palette. But for each look, I'm not sure if I mentioned it in the voiceover, but for each look, the transition shades are absolutely stunning and they'd be stunning on their own. So I feel like this is a very, very basic palette. You can get all your basic needs out of this palette. I do feel like it is lacking a little bit of creativity, a little more pops of colour. I was instantly drawn towards the Mulberry shade, which is this one here, and the Plum shade, which is this one here. The blend of each shadow is incredible. The pigmentation is there. There's not too much kickback on the palette, only a small bit. And you have a black, which is so essential in a palette. Sometimes I feel like it is, sometimes I feel like it isn't. For this palette in particular, because it does carry such a broad range of basic colors, the black is so essential, so that you can just carry this palette with you if you're going traveling, or if you want to just grab a neutral look for the day, you can just grab this palette and that black will be there to guide you if you do need some liner or to darken out the outer corners. This row here is full of the metallic creamy shades that give you that beautiful shine. They're incredible. They're super creamy, really nice, really easy to work with. There's also that chocolate shade, which I used in one of the looks as well, and that is stunning as well. So you do get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 metallic shades. You get 6 metallic shades, all the rest are completely matte, which is, it's a nice mixture, but I do feel like it is lacking some type of colors to give you more inspiration, but it is a great basic palette. If Madison do come out with any more palettes, I will definitely be on their list to purchase. Madison did send me this palette in PR, but of course all my opinions are 100% true to how I feel. Do I recommend this palette? I do if you're looking for a really basic palette that will give you everything you need for basic looks. Everyday looks, looks that you want to glam up but not have any pops of color. If you have other products at home that you can add a bit of glitter, a bit of spice onto your lids, then this is a good palette if you just want to get like basic neutral tones. I want to know if you have this palette or if you're thinking of getting it, if your thoughts are similar. Again, the eyeshadow formulas themselves are really, really well made, which is like an essential. Blending is so easy. Let me know your thoughts. Looking at this palette, first impression, what would you think? And I'd love to hear what you think in the comments below. So I hope you enjoyed the three looks that I created. Give me a thumbs up if you did, and make sure to subscribe to the channel if you like what you see. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.